Okay, so this is part two of the lecture regarding the design and production of an ad. As I was explaining, the printing process, the last part of the slide where the first video ended, as far as the printing process is concerned, the two common printing processes are one, which is the traditional one where these four colors or multicolored ads are printed through a four-step process, whereby each of the colors on paper is printed single time. So, for example, one printing machine, commercial printing machine, industrial printing machine will have the black color, another will have the blue, another will have the red, and another, the fourth one will have the yellow. So these four colors are put across four different machines and the paper goes through all four of them, resulting in the final multicolored ad that you see. Compared to that, the other more updated printing process is the single step process, very similar to how we print colored pages on our computer printers or home printers or office printers, where you simply put the page once and it prints all different colors simultaneously. So all the Panaflex that you see, many of these billboards that you see on the side of the roads, these are all printed using this single step process, where there are big commercial printers in which these Panaflex plastic sheets are put instead of paper, and through a single go from the computer command, the printing takes place. So moving further, as far as the radio ads are concerned, the design and production of radio ads involves understanding on part of the designer regarding the tools. The three tools, as I mentioned in week 8, and I'm revising them here, are voice, music, and sound effects. So how these three will be used, how these will be combined, is one of the key elements of a radio ad. As you all know, radio has only the audio component. There is no visual available. Similarly, the designer of a radio ad has to have an understanding of the fact that radio is a transitory medium. This is something I mentioned last week also, whereby I told you that many a times the radio listener is not paying attention. It is obvious that he's not looking at a screen, for example, when he is listening to the radio. So he or she is busy, driving the car while listening to the radio. They are on the move. They might be busy in their home related work, or might be reading something. So that's why they are busy doing something else, and as a result, transition. So that's the idea of a transitory medium. So the designer or producer of an ad has to understand that he or she has the audio elements only, the tools, voice, music, and sound effects, to capture the attention of the listener who is in transition, who is not fully attentive. Similarly, radio is a theater of the mind, which means that when we listen to radio content, audio content, we visualize things, we visualize people in our mind as to how they will look like, just by simply listening. So for example, if you are listening to a song only, you can imagine how the singer looks like. Similar is the case with such radio commercials or ads as well, where we create a theater in our mind. And when we say image transfer means that many a times radio ads are derived from the audio files of the TV ad of the same brand. So this is a very cost-effective method used by different brands, whereby they have already produced a TV or digital commercial or advertisement, and picking up the voice, music, and sound effects from their TV or digital ad, they convert it into an audio file and present that as a radio ad. So if the listener has already watched the TV or digital ad, he can automatically transfer the image or visualize the images in his mind. So this aspect also has to be kept in mind as far as the designing and production of radio ads is concerned. Moving further, when it comes to designing and production of TV and digital ads, especially digital ads which have a video content along with audio, because that is the characteristic of TV commercials also, the tools are much more, and the technicalities are much at a much higher level. So, for example, the three audio tools which are available to not just radio ad producers, but also television and digital ad producers are the voice, music, and sound effects, which you already know. But besides that, designer or producer of a television or digital ad has to understand other tools. For example, characters. By characters, we mean the roles which will be performed by different actors. So, for example, the role of an old man, the role of the character of the father, or the character of the housewife. So that's what we mean by characters. Costumes also is an important tool for TV and digital production. If you're going to be showing certain characters, those characters, their personalities, will be enhanced through the character. Is that of a business executive, as per the story or requirement of the copy or copywriting of the ad. If the requirement is that of a character of an executive of a company, so the costume has to be very formal. Similarly, if the character is that of a poor man, the costume has to be provided accordingly. So costumes are also an element of or tool of the design and production aspect or dimension. Similarly, when you talk about set or location, it means that where will the ad or the video content of the ad where will it be filmed? For example, when you say location, as some of you might know, location means the natural setting. So for example, if the copy of the ad requires or the story of the ad requires that the some of the shots or one scene has to be filmed on the beach or inside an office. So if the director takes his team to the actual beach or goes to an actual office or an actual home, this is called on-location filming. Most of the dramas that you see on television, they are produced on location. That is, they are produced at actual offices or actual houses, or not at artificial houses. On the other hand, most of the talk shows that you watch on television, radio, the news programs, analysis, satire shows, etc., other kinds of shows, these are all mostly filmed on set. By set, I mean that are filmed inside purpose-built studios, at on location. Next is the concept of props. Props means all those objects which are provided or which are visible to you on the screen. So if the view of a house inside for a TV commercial or ad, and the table, the sofa, the lamp, etc., these are all props. So all such objects which provide a backdrop to the scene, and the actors use these or the directors use these to present a comprehensive visual image, these are called props. For example, in one of the scenes or shots, if the actor is holding a mobile phone in his hand while talking to someone, so the phone is a prop. On-screen graphics and special effects, this refers to different kinds of computer effects which are generated. If you see certain text coming in front of you on the screen, any shape coming in front of you on the screen, moving around, all on-screen graphics and special effects. And lighting is already mentioned, plays a very important role in terms of enhancing the visual appeal of the ad or the on-screen appeal of the ad. And I will share a video with you along with my video talk, and you can watch that video link to understand what it means to use lighting and graphics and special effects creatively along with props to present a comprehensive, impactful commercial or ad to the audience. The concept of off-camera and voiceover has to be understood as well. This is something I mentioned during week 8 also, but when just to revise this a little bit, off-camera means that when in a commercial or ad, you see, for example, two actors talking to each other, on the screen visually, you see actor number one being shown, but he is, for example, quiet, and the actor number two is talking, but he is not visible on the screen. Rather, the camera is only focusing on actor number one who is listening. So in this case, the voice of the second actor, the one who is not visible on the screen, this is called off-camera voice. When we say voiceover, voiceover simply means all background voice. For example, in the case of documentary programs, for example, a documentary on the lions or animals, any other wild animals, you will find that the narration provided in the background, that is called the voiceover. So in the case of ads and commercials also, voiceover technique is also used very commonly. As far as this concept of short scene and keyframe is concerned, again, I had explained this, but just to tell you that as far as planning a TV or digital commercial is concerned, it is planned in the form of short scenes and keyframe. Keyframe is the single most important shot. Usually it is a shot in which the actor is holding the product, or the it is a shot in which only the product is being focused upon. It can be in the middle of an ad, it can be at the very end of an ad. So it is not always easy to identify the keyframe, but usually it's the most important or central part of the story of an ad. And it is usually a single shot. Scene is a collection of shots, as I told you. Shot is a single camera angle whereby a single object or something is shown. So when we say an ad is a combination of one keyframe, possibly three or four scenes maximum, and 10, 20, 30, 40 shots. That's how the sequencing works. Not always, but this gives you a sense of the breakup of the TV or digital ad. Next is the concept of storyboarding, which is very important. On your right, you see the storyboarding here. Storyboard is putting your story or the copy or the story of the ad through these graphics or drawings to give it a visual sense. For example, if I show it to you here, of the movie Finding Nemo, the making of the movie. So this is the director. He's trying to explain some aspect. I'm not going to show the video, but behind him, this is the storyboard. So because this is an animated movie, so this tells us that the whole movie has been planned using the storyboarding concept. So for example, if you keep watching this, I deliberately kept the sound mute because of the technical problem. So this is how storyboard is being created. And the background, you see lots of so because this is a movie, so a lot of planning has happened. But when it comes to a commercial, the duration is not more than a minute. So in that case, such detailed storyboarding is not required, but it gives you a sense of what I'm trying to say, what storyboard means. So TV and digital ad producers, they also use storyboards or photo boards. And this storyboard is very important because it is supposed to be presented to the client or the sponsor. And once the client approves the storyboard or the photo board, only then the actual production of the ad or filming begins. Please note down that on this slide, you see the statement, storyboard is a requirement for group presentation. Please ignore this. The reason is that this was valid for the regular class session as when the group presentation was planned. Now that we are into the Google Classroom and taking online classes, as I told you at the very beginning of these online classes, there is no group presentation, so storyboard is no longer required for group presentation either. Finally, as far as digital ads are concerned, they are usually in the following three, four broad formats: web page or website, banner, and internet ad. The details of these I will provide during week 11, when I'll be explaining digital advertising, especially social media advertising. So all this will be covered next week. Finally, moving towards the last part of this video lecture, these are the four steps of design and production of a TV or digital ad. Please note that these four steps are also somewhat the same for producing a movie or producing a drama as well. So any content, any video-based content that is produced, it involves these four steps. I'm going to be discussing them with special reference to the TV ad or digital ad production process only. So the four steps are message design, pre-production, production, and post-production. When it comes to message design, this is all the planning phase, pre-planning sort of, where the client gets approval on the advertising strategy. The advertising agency gets this approval from the client. So this connects with our concept of creative leap, if you remember from our discussion on creative advertising 2 weeks ago. So this advertising strategy is what the client or the sponsor has, and the advertising agency and the creative team or within the agency has to get approval on this strategy from the client, because they will use this strategy to then build the creative leap using the principle of creativity. Once they have this strategy approval from the client, then the message is, the format of the message is decided by message format. It means that whether the ad will be through the print medium, whether it will be through the radio medium, whether it will be through the television or digital medium, or all four of them. So the format means which of these four or all four of them will be the media through which the ad will be presented. Next, the keyframe is decided, because as I mentioned, this is a TV or digital ad, so the keyframe is the central point of an ad. So this is also planned during the message design phase. The script is finalized. By script, we mean the copy. It's the same thing. So the copywriting process results in the copy or the script. So this is finalized during message design. The storyboard is prepared, as I mentioned just a while ago. So this storyboard is then approved through a presentation to the client along with the script of the copy. So the script and storyboard, once these are finalized or approved by the client, we move to the next step, which is pre-production. Within pre-production, in some cases, in some advertisement projects or ad production projects, the director or the creative director is decided during pre-production phase, while in some other cases the director is decided within the message design stage, the first one. So you don't need to worry about it. It's not that important. It can be a step during pre-production, or it can be a step during the message design. Another aspect within pre-production is the finalization of the production house or animation house. Now, please remember that in case of most advertising agencies, they do not produce the ad themselves. Reason is that production of an ad involves expensive equipment, cameras, different kind of digital devices, recording devices, engineering equipment, and many of these advertising agencies do not invest in such expensive equipments, which run into millions of dollars in some cases. For example, if you watch an ad for a food product where you see slow motion effects, for example, the fruit being cut into two pieces, or oil being poured into a pan, slow motion effects, visual effects. So these are filmed using very advanced camera and technologies and lens. So these are usually not available with the advertising agency, and rather production houses, which are specialized companies who provide these services on rent or on charge basis. So this production house or animation house is going to be hired during the pre-production phase. Advertising agencies mainly responsible for the script, the storyboarding, the advertising strategy. That is their main focus. And many advertising agencies do not have their production, their own production facilities. Then some further pre-production meetings are going to take place, which means that the creative director will get in touch with representatives from the production house. He will, you know, communicate with his copywriter, his art directors, other team members. So these background meetings takes place. This is like preliminary work before the actual production begins, which is step three. Casting the talent refers to, locate or build a set, which means that set or location is identified. I have already mentioned this in the previous slide. Similarly, casting the talent means that relevant actors are identified. These are the actors who are going to play the characters. So this process of identifying actors for playing specific characters or role, this is called casting. Props are located or arranged, costumes are arranged, other photographic images or visuals are arranged, photographers are involved, and so on and so forth. Some of these TV commercials will have still images, so for that you need special kinds of photographs which will be placed during different parts of a commercial, so you might need photographers also. And then get bids for all the production operations, which means that most of this work is outsourced, so the creative director would be interested in getting bids, which means he's going to get quotations from different production houses. He's going to get quotations on the props, because these are going to be on the rent basis, and so on and so forth. And he's going to get bids or quotations on the charges for the location. So all this is worked out in pre-production. Moving to the third stage, this is called production, where the actual shooting or actual recording takes place. This involves the creative director or the director managing all the recording on location or on set. This involves a couple of things which are done separately. For example, all the visual content or action is recorded separately. On film, by film we mean this can be a digital medium, as you all know. So now you can record movies using the digital devices. That is done separately. Then the music, voices, and sound effects are recorded separately. Especially the sound effects and music, they are not recorded while the action is being filmed. Some of the voices are recorded when the action is being filmed, but other music, voiceover, etc., and sound effects, these are all recorded through separate arrangements, which is completely different from the recording of the action or video content. On-screen graphics and computer graphics are arranged using the help of animation houses, as mentioned during step two. So all these three, the visual or video content, the audio content, and the on-screen and computer graphics are arranged separately. Once all these three are arranged, then we move to the post-production phase, where editing of the film takes place, which means that any unnecessary shots from different scenes that the director feels are going to prolong the duration of the commercial or ad unnecessarily, those are removed, and different shots are connected with other shots in a very seemingly unnoticeable way, so that the audience does not even feel that he or she is being transitioned from one part of the story to the other, So it goes very smoothly. So this is the job of the editor, the film editor. Then the mixing of audio track takes place, which means that the voice, the music, and the sound effects are combined together to generate a single audio file. Synchronization means that the video and the audio are matched or joined together in such a way that when you watch, you do not feel that these have been recorded separately. Rather, they look as if everything has taken place simultaneously. Once this is synchronization is done, you have the final file or the copy of the ad in visual form. So this is presented to the client for approval, and once the approval is granted, copies of this ad or commercial are made, and they are provided to different, for example, TV channel administrations or different websites or web administrators, depending on which kind of media is going to be used for running this ad or commercial. So with this, we come to the end of the presentation. Besides this, I would like to show you the Intel channel. As some of you might know, that many multinationals or international brands, and even national brands in Pakistan, they use different forum, digital media to advertise and promote. So many companies have active social media pages, they have YouTube pages or YouTube channels. So this is just one example of Intel. I will share the link with you. And in the case of Intel, the peculiarity is that they are producers of a technology, they are producers of technology products, and these products are very complex in terms of how they work. So it is very difficult to communicate a message about these products or advertise these products. So you need a lot of emphasis on a strong understanding of the design and production aspects to commercially present these products through ads. So if you have the time, do watch some of their ads, which are visible in front of you. I'm not going to show these ads because of the sound problems within Google Meet, but it will give you a sense of what I mean by the design and production elements or the importance of these different tools like props, like sound, like sound effects, like music, etc., how they are all combined together to present their products. Just to demonstrate to you, I'm going to show this ad to you. I've kept the sound mute, but the idea is just to tell you what I mean by design and production. So for example, you see these on-screen graphics or computer-generated effects. This is an ad for Core i9 processor, 2 years ago probably. So as you see this in front of you, the idea is to understand what it means to design and produce an ad, and how you combine colors, visuals, and obviously when you watch this, with the sound, of obviously the impact is going to be much stronger. So the way the camera moves, the zoom in, the zoom out shots, the other special effects, colors, all this is part and parcel of the design and production of a visually enhancing or impactful ad. So let me stop here. With this, I come to the end of my presentation. This video is part two of the talk that I originally started with regards to ad design and production. So you have to watch these two parts simultaneously to fully grasp the topic for week 9. Thank you very much for your time. I'll see you next week, inshallah. Allah Hafiz.